So we're gonna factor the left side, and while we could do guessing and checking, and I'm not gonna fault you for doing that if that's what you wanna do, I'm going to do it this way.
84.
Okay. So 6 times negative 14?
Negative 84.
Negative 84. I mean, double lose five. Negative 84. Negative 5. Two numbers that multiply to negative 84 add to negative 5. Might take a couple tries, but we'll get there. We have it. Two numbers that multiply to negative. Well, if they multiply to a negative, what do I know about these two numbers?
Oh, I got that.
One's a positive and one's a negative.
Got it. Positive and negative.
It's negative 12 and 7.
Negative 12 and 7?
Or either or with the negative.
Either or?
No.
Well, no, just kidding. Negative 12 because then it would make the negative 5 on bottom.
Yes, so we need the 12 to be negative, so we get the negative 5.
Yeah.
There. Very good. Should I make sure 12 is 7? 7, 2, 14, yeah. Okay. Okay, here's a kind of a heads up, warning you, watch out. Don't make this common mistake that people make. They take the 7 and the negative 12, they did all the work to find those two numbers, and they just plop them into the parentheses as if that's what those were for. That's not what they're for. Here's what they're for. We're going to split the negative 5 into 7m minus 12m. That's what those are for. And then, as so many times before, we're going to make this color darker. Highlight this, that's the yellow, we'll highlight this other guy, this purple color. You look at that first group, split them into two groups, look at the first group, and decide that in that first group, what? First group has
a 1m.
1m in common, m times 6m plus 7. Look at that purple group. They have the negative there tells me factor out negative 2. So choose the right number to make sure it's negative so that our parentheses will match up the way they're supposed to. Well, the negative, so this would be a positive 6m. Negative 2 times 6m is negative 12m. Negative 2 times a positive 7 gives us the negative 14. And we have two terms. Here's the yellow term and the purple term. Both yellow and purple have a 6m plus 7 factor. So we'll factor out that 6m plus 7, which leaves us with an m and a negative 2. It's all equal to 0. Set each factor equal to 0. Subtract 7, 6m equals negative 7, divide by 6, negative 7 is 6. This one's easier, add 2 to both sides, n is 2. Any questions, comments, anything at all about that number?
Nope.
All right, 28, it's in the can. Number, something else, 46. Do this problem or watch this problem be done, it's going to look very, very similar to what we just did. It's a lot of the same stuff, factoring, setting each factor to 0, and so on. The only other thing is that we've done this one time before, where it asks us to find the zeros of the function.
Just
Trevin instead of Trevor.
I was in bio too.
It was like the worst class to miss.
Your new name's Trevin.
You finished that though?
Yeah.
Okay, so let me repeat that. The thing that they want us to do is to find the zeros of this function. Find the zeros. Here's what a zero is. It's kind of a weird thing to call this, because most often a zero is not zero. A zero is a some number. And when I plug that number in for x into this equation, the result, the y value, the output, is the zero.
Oh, so it's just like
solving that equation.
Yeah, again.
So to find the zeros, again, the output is zero. What input gives an output of zero? Well, we set it equal to zero, we solve that equation. I'd say first things first, this is like step zero. If I look at all those three terms there on the left side, what do you notice about all three of them? What's that?
Divisible by 2.
So it's both. Divide both sides by 2. Divide this by 2.
Gosh, Stuart, don't have your phone class.
Put it in phone jail, I guess. Turn it on.
You really
doing
it? Okay.
I had mine in phone jail earlier.
Okay.
Touch.
Yeah, I was supposed to have it on Do Not Disturb, I guess I forgot. You just thought, divide this by 2, divide 0 by 2. What's 0 divided by 2?
Nothing.
So just still 0.
Make that number.
Divide each of these by 2, we get 4x squared minus 3x minus 7.
Way easier.
Yeah, the numbers are smaller. I could have done it without dividing out the 2, but it's easier if I go ahead and get rid of that 2. Gets rid of one of the factors that I would have to worry about when I do this. Okay. Or feel free to guess and check if you want to guess and check. So 4 times negative 7 is negative 28. Then we throw the negative 3 down there. Two numbers that multiply to negative 28 and add to negative 3.
8? No.
No, 8's not a factor of 28. Let's see, it's not 7. And
is
it 7? It is 7. Four and negative 7.
Yeah, that works.
Just so happens. All right, so 4x squared plus 4x minus 7x minus 7. These two have a 4 in common, 4x in common, 4x times x plus 1. These two have a negative 7 in common, negative 7 times x plus 1. They both have a factor of x plus 1. X plus 1, we're left with 4x minus 7. It's all equal to 0. X plus 1 equals 0. Subtract 1 from both sides. X is negative 1. 4x minus 7 equals 0. Add 7. Divide by 4. So now what we say about these is negative 1 is 7. Negative 1 is a 0 to this function, which means, simply, if I plug a negative 1 in for x, and I add all the numbers together, do all the math, I'll come out with 0 as the output. 7 fourths is also a 0. Put 7 fourths right there, put 7 fourths right there, add it all together, you get 0. That's what we just figured out. Those are the zeros for that function. If we were to graph this, which we will sometime in the near future, if we were to graph g of x equals 8x squared minus 6x minus 14, that's where the graph would cross the x-axis, because that's where y is 0. Yeah?
So I had an extra problem on the homework. It said 78, but there is no 78.
It's there.
It's there.
You gotta just keep turning them pages.
I did.
I don't know what to
say. It looks different than the rest of the problems, but it's there.
It's right there.
Oh, geez. That sucks. Who assigns 81?
That's too good. Besides workspace. 78. The reason I assigned this one is because it is especially of interest today. So this will give us a little preview for the day, actually. We multiply these together, 5n times 5n, 25n squared. 5n times 3 is 15n. Then we come back over here and get a negative 3 times 5n, I get a negative 15n. You can see what's going to happen there when I try to add those two like terms together. Negative 3 times 3 is negative 9.
Yeah.
15n minus 15n is?
Zero.
Zero. There's nothing in the middle. So we have 25n squared minus 9.
Mm-hmm.
The reason why that's pertinent to today is we're going to be factoring stuff like that. So this looks a little strange, looks a little different.
So you just square root the first one?
Shut up, Carson, I know. We were stuck on this problem we were working on, so I could see which one was right, and apparently he got it right.
Ah, thank you, Carson. Giving him the look. I was right. So, yeah, 25n squared, you'll notice 25 is a square number, n is a square number, 9 is a square number. And they're subtracted, as we call it, difference of squares. It's not the first time we've said a difference of squares.
Is it an inequality?
Is it an inequality?
Mm-hmm.
No, it's not an inequality. An inequality is like, you got equations with equal signs and inequalities with greater than or less than signs.
Is this what the test is going to be? I mean, not the test, the quiz.
On this particular one thing?
Yeah. Like
no.
There. Okay.
So we're going to keep talking about how we can recognize special difference of squares pattern and use it to factor these things. Wait. Okay, here we go. So we'll draw the little X thing like I've been teaching you. We got a negative 70 when we multiply 2 times negative 35. Negative 3. Two numbers that multiply to negative 7 and you add to negative 3.
Negative 10
and 7.
10 and
7.
Which is
negative 10. Negative
10. Mm.
And
7. Oh my god.
Alright. Now. This, I know it's pretty neat. I call it 10 or 7. But a couple of people say just during the review, and that was just people who said so, that they weren't sure what they were supposed to do next.
I did.
No, I don't know what to do, because I even specifically said, hey, look at me, be careful, don't make the mistake that a lot of people make, and do this wrong thing with these numbers, do this right thing with these numbers, right? And it's not the first time I've said that. Okay. So pay close attention here. We found the negative 10 and the 7, and we're going to take the negative 10 and 7, they're really negative 10x and 7x, because we want this 3x to split up into negative 10x plus 7x. We can put them back together. Negative 10x plus 7x is negative 3x. But the whole point of this was we're going to make two groups out of this, and we want to find just the right numbers to split negative 3x into so that they share factors with the 2 and the 35 so that this next step will work. Walk away with nothing else. These guys here are what you split this middle term into. Write it down, put a big starburst around it.
Starburst.
As you're writing down your notes that I know you're taking. Create invisible notes. Jason, what's your question?
I already know what happens.
Okay, stay tuned.
Stay tuned for the next show.
I don't want.
Alright, so we look at this first group, and we look at this as a second group, so we would call factoring by grouping, which we'll use next section after today. This first group has what in common?
2x,
leaving us with x minus 5.
Nice.
And this group?
7.
Just a 7, leaving us with, surprise, surprise, x minus 5 again.
Whoa.
Well, or it could
could just be one modified, right?
Yeah, but then you wouldn't have the same common.
It's gotta be x minus 5. If these aren't the same.
I know, but I mean like 1x.
Yeah, 1x. Yeah.
It is 1x.
X is 1x.
It's just all alone.
I'll put a 1 there if I want 1 times x. They both have a factor of x minus 5. And these just for the 2x plus 7 when we take the x minus 5 from each of those. Zero. Set each factor equal to zero.
Yeah.
Plus 7 equals zero. Add 5 on both sides, we get x is 5.
Yeah.
Subtract 7 from both sides, you get negative 7. Divide by 2, negative 7.
Alright. Next.
Okay, so good news, bad news. I guess bad news, good news. Bad news is we have more factoring. Good news is there's more factoring. it's bad news, good is what I'm saying. Like
it's just news.
Maybe you're tired of factoring. Okay. But if you feel like you're getting a little bit behind, there's still time to catch up because we're just doing more factoring. Just kind of throwing another tool your way and use it in your factoring careers. In a way, it's better than moving on to something new if you're feeling like you're behind. You have a little more time with factoring to get familiarized. Practice and practice and practice. So, like I said, today we're going to focus on factoring a special kind of pattern that we just saw, number 78 from the homework. Let me show you a quick example. Something like 4x squared minus 9. I think the number is kind of small. 4x squared minus 9. As an experienced factorer, I know that this is a difference of squares, and I'd factor it as 2x plus 3 and 2x minus 3. As a cautious but experienced factorer, I'm just going to make sure. I'm going to make sure that this is the factored form of that. Okay, 2x times 2x is 4x squared. 2x times negative 3, negative 6x. Now 3 times 2x, that's a positive 6x.
Negative 9.
3 times negative 3 is negative 9. So I can see, and we've done this quite a few times. Like we've multiplied factors like this together before. When we were learning how to multiply these together, we multiplied some of these.
Yeah.
And wound up with the middle term canceling. Mm-hmm. As I said before, we've factored difference of squares before. It's just that I did kind of the favor of always making sure that was a 1 out in front instead of another number. Right. So it's not our first rodeo, but we're reintroducing it. What happens if there's a number in front of the x squared besides 1? As long as it's a square number, we can factor it just like that.
Mm-hmm.
2x plus 3, 2x minus 3. And so I've checked it, and I don't really want all this mess there. Back it up and say that, yeah, that's how it factors. The difference of squares factors. But how about, like, if I have practiced a few times, maybe I'm getting the hang of it. Like, I see this 4 is a square, x squared is a square, 9 is a square. So how do I know it's 2x plus 3, 2x minus 3? Like, what connection do you see between 2x and 4?
Because 2x can be distributed out of 4 and 3 can be distributed out of 8. I mean 9.
Yeah, so, and it's a special number. It's not just any factor of 4, it's a factor that has an identical factor. So what kind of number do we call that?
Square root.
Okay,
yeah.
Which is the square root? 4 or is 2 the square root?
2 is the square root of 4.
Yes,
2
is the square root of
4. 3 is the square root of 9.
The square root of 9. So 9 is a square number and 4 is a square number.
So distribution is the opposite of square.
No, they're in the same family.
If it's the same.
Hmm? Distribution and squaring is multiplying the number by itself.
Like
distribution
is
multiplying
okay,
numbers together.
You have to. That's the distributed out one. And
yeah,
that's the squared root version.
The
that's
factor,
what I'm trying to say.
Factor, yeah.
Yeah.
So distributed or multiplied, factored or
square rooted.
But this isn't exactly how a square root. This isn't identical to each other. So look for that missing middle term. That middle term is not there. There's no x's. Think difference of squares, perhaps.
I'll try one.
Let's try it. 16 x squared minus 25. Okay. Try it yourself. Right now. Don't wait until you're not sure what to do on, what is this, Wednesday, when you're not sure what to do on Friday? No, this is Thursday, when you're not sure what to do on Monday.
Mm-hmm.
Let's practice now.
What's today? Oh, my gosh,
anymore. Just let's practice 16x squared minus 25. Factor it just like I've shown you. All
right.
Twice already today. So my experience from this previous example, the example from the homework, we're going the other way, we're multiplying two factors very much like this together. We know that they're gonna look almost exactly the same. That's really important, because if they're not, if the numbers aren't exactly the same, then there's no way that middle thing's gonna cancel out.
Yeah.
Because we're gonna get two different combinations of numbers and it's not gonna cancel out. So what do you think? It looks like Jenna's ready to tell us what this one is.
4x plus 5 and then 4x minus 5.
4x minus 5. Did you multiply them out to double check? You did, and it worked? When you do that, I mean, it affects your brain. When you double check, it affects your brain much differently than watching me check it. You check it, and you'll like get the feeling of that middle term canceling out. Your brain will make a connection. It'll be like, oh, I see why it would cancel out. Because in one way, I take a 4x times a negative 5, I get a negative 20x. But then right after that, I take a 5, positive 5 times positive 4x, I get a positive 20x. There's that cancellation comes out. And that helps it to make even further sense why these have to be like this and this have to be the same, this and this have to be the same. Otherwise, that cancellation is never going to happen. And of course, you have to have a positive one and a negative one.
Got it.
Solid.
Let's see. One more. And then I got this feeling like I'm forgetting something, so I'll need to just look at my notes in a second. Let's say 49n to the fourth minus 36. 49n to the fourth, notice there's a 4 there, it's not a 2. So I see a lot of people with the first step. And I'm telling you, there's a second step. There's more factoring to do. So what would it look like if I just factor this difference of squares?
4x, 2.
4x squared.
Mm-hmm.
What is that? Plus 9.
And 4x squared plus 9.
All right. And I'm saying that's correct. But there's more that we can do, yeah?
You can divide the 4. Like, okay, so you can have the 2. So it'll be 2x to the 4
plus
2. No, 2x to the squared. No, it'd be. Oh, yeah. No, because it's trying to go into 16 because you're trying
to
multiply
even
more.
Factor more.
So it'd be 2 times 2 equals 4. 4 times 2 equals 8. 8 times 2 equals 16. So it'd be 2 to the 4th.
That's true.
2 to the 4th?
Yes.
Or if I look at it upside down.
Oh, I got to figure it out.
I think it would be 2 to the 2nd.
No, again, you're trying to apply this square to the number in front of it that doesn't apply to this.
It would be 4x squared, huh? Because
well,
you got the 2, you got the x equals the thing.
You ruined that. X is its own thing, it's being squared, not being squared.
It's 2x squared plus 9, and then 2x squared minus 9. That's what I had.
2x squared plus 9 and 2x squared minus 9?
Yes.
What would that be?
Hmm. 4x squared.
That'd be 4x not squared.
I know, it'd be the 4th.
To the 4th.
Oh,
no, 4x to the 4th.
To the 4th, bro.
So it would just be. Would it just be 2x then? Because
2x and 2x?
Yeah, because then we go 4x and 9 times 9.
Oh, it's 4x squared.
9 times 9 is 81, but we still have this guy.
Yeah, you got 2x times 2x because you're distributing. Equal
4x. 4x squared.
Yeah.
Is this what you were trying to do?
It's close.
Oh.
It's just that.
Three.
This, all of this, what we're talking about, should multiply back together. Like, this is its own difference than squares.
Oh, no, it'd be like...
So ignoring this for a second, not making it disappear, but just not looking at it for a second. Look at this thing. It's also a difference than squares.
Oh, you got it.
So just like this is a difference of squares and it factors like this, if I gave this to you, like on one of the previous examples, you would have factored it as 2x plus 3 and 2x minus 3.
Yeah, plus or minus
3. I was
you just keep factoring until you can't factor no more.
I was close to the negative.
Factor one.
Like, 24. If I factor 24 as 6 times 4, well, then I'll factor the 6 as 2 times 3 and the 4 is 2 times 2. And we're getting it down to its prime factors in the polynomial land. These are what you call prime. You can't factor them anymore. This one's also prime, right? It's got a 4x squared and it's got a 9. But that addition means we'll never find two factors to multiply together so that that middle term gets canceled out. Because it's that negative that allows that to happen. It's the positive and the negative that multiply to a negative that also wind up canceling each other out in the middle term. So with a plus, it doesn't work. There is no sum of squares pattern, only a difference of squares. It's the only way you can factor it in that particular circumstance.